Hey everyone, this is Matt from Studio 41, and we're finally here with Rogue Squadron 2 Let's Play. It's been quite a while since I made that announcement, back in January, I believe. No, December of last year. And this Let's Play has been quite the mess. I've had to deal with files not working, I've had to deal with this capture card messing up all the time, and I had to deal with just school, work, and also getting distracted by a bunch of other things. Witcher, Call of Duty, Titanfall 2, Battlefield 1, all these other games I've been distracted by that took me away from this. So here's what I'm gonna do. Just for this episode, we're going straight into the Tatooine training. I'm probably not gonna be able to cover everything in it, but it's just something I want to throw into the Let's Play. That, and I know it's really long, like I said, not long-winded, I mean, just been a long time since the year Star Wars ended. I may just want to go and talk on about it, so you're going to have the option of either staying here, watch me play through Tatooine training, talk about the year Star Wars and anything else, or you can just continue on to the first mission, which will be the Death Star attack, so it's completely up to you. So let's begin. Alright, so we have 20 minutes to fly around and do all the training. And for people who are new to this series, this is actually a really good game to start off on, since none of the Rogue Squadron games are connected in any way. And use the bomb, some womp rats. Yeah, since all the Rogue Squadron games are not connected in any way, they're fairly easy to pick up without having to worry about plot or anything, if that's something you're concerned about. And I just blew up Luke's home. So now we have the option of doing whatever. What if you want to race a few people? What if you want to get used to controls? It's all up to you whenever you get to this. There is no set goals you have to get if you're trying to unlock anything in the game. It's just training, just something for really your own benefit. I know there is something you think you can get if you unlock everything, but for some reason this game, it's glitched, so whenever I try to unlock everything, it won't register it, so yeah. And let's see. Also, you do have lives, so you don't want to mess it up, because if you die or lose all three of your lives, then it's counted as an end of the mission, so you don't have to it won't restart, give you a mission failed. Yeah, this part where you're bombing womp rats. They want you to bomb up womp rats, but for the most part, you can just shoot them. You destroyed more than 60 womp rats. And then right here, you just press start. You'll be able to see your objectives, and you can see I've filled in all the objectives. The one thing is that there will be stuff that will show up that you previously won't see at first, just because for races, they want you to do them twice, and for the womp rat things, they want you to do that again, so that way you have your easy mode, your middle, and like expert for your each objective. But it's fairly simple. I'm not really going to be going into how you do all the controls and everything, since at least in the flight training, it's pretty much all self-explanatory once you do training.
Try pressing the D-pad now.
Like there, it just gave me that whole thing about pressing the D-pad to make your commands, even though it'll go on for a little bit. I just try to keep it separate for a while.
You can roll your craft by holding down the Z trigger. Try rolling your
hold down Z
now.
to roll your craft.
Good work.
And this is something that I like to practice with, though it's not very effective, but you try to do more flight simmy kind of thing where you roll your craft to turn as opposed to just regularly turning. It would be something I would like to see implemented, but I don't think in this game you can do that.
You can slow your craft by gently squeezing the left.
Lightly press the
try it now.
Left trigger to brake, right trigger to boost, and if you press it all the way down, it'll give you speed boost. And then if you press the left trigger all the way down, you'll be able to stop. Well, slow down to close to stop. You can brake hard by jamming on the left shoulder. Yeah, hard braking. Until it stops. Try it now. Excellent. So yeah, so about the year of Star Wars. I'm gonna say it was something that I expected out of us. I pretty much expected that we were gonna be rushing things at the end of the year just because, for one, none of us really had that many Star Wars games. I was the only one who had maybe one or two at first, but then I had to go back and buy a bunch of them. And actually, I recently got Star Wars or Shadows of the Empire, but I'm not reviewing that since I've already made my statement back in August that I wasn't going to be reviewing any more games. But with the year Star Wars, but yeah, it's just, it was kind of one of the things that we just wanted, I thought would be fun for our studio to do, just because, it was, you know, Star Wars is making her comeback. There was this perfect opportunity to at least do something that would at least have everyone on the same track, since most of the stuff on our channel at least is very much Jeff-centric, since Jeff pretty much keeps all the content flowing on our channel, because other Chris, the one who has Mega Anime Freak or Webhead, whichever, he actually recently got a PlayStation 4, so he's able to get some gameplay onto our site. And other Chris, he doesn't own a capture card, and so he never does anything with our channel. So, kind of coming up with this whole year of Star Wars thing, it was pretty much asking for it to not go that well. And then on my part, it was just for me getting the time to get in through all these games, kind of collecting my thoughts that, and just my own thing about reviews that I'm not really that great at them. That's why I didn't enter the Whenever the Hell contest back in February, but Jeff did that, and well, if you ever want to look at it, you can, you know, just look up A Salieri, Whenever the Hell, and you'll be able to see what they thought of Jeff's video, though I will say it's pretty brutal what they did. But, moving on.
Good job. You found Jabba's palace.
Not much to say after the whole year of Star Wars thing, but so far though, we are not doing another one, any kind of year of or anything like that, unless it's someone doing that on their own. And yes, I indeed just blew up Jabba's palace. And there's this thing, which I think is C-3PO. Yep, C-3PO. We do. Yeah, and you can find R2-D2 somewhere around here, along with the escape pod.
You can accelerate your craft by gently squeezing the right shoulder button. Try it now. Good job.
Now, one thing that's pretty cool with this game is that the
use the Y button to call up your targeting
computer. The sunlight changes depending on what time of day you play. So since I'm playing in the evening, it's sunset, even though right now here in November it is already dark out, but I'm thinking this is just set to whatever, I guess, an equal sunlight, equal night.
Race against Biggs and Wedge to Tosche Station.
And I've never seen a game ever since have a day-night system like that, where it's actively linked to the console's internal clock. And this was done back in 2001, I believe so, because this game was a release title for the GameCube. Now, the second time you do this race, it's a lot more challenging, since your opponents are flying on essentially constant boost, so you gotta really keep an eye on that. And I hope my game isn't freezing up, because you're encountering some real heavy frame rate drop. Really hope my game isn't... Okay, never mind. I know it's normal for me to encounter frame rate drop during the last mission, but we'll get to that whenever that happens, and I really gotta speed up. Because of that, you have to boost. There we go. The last time I did that, when I first did my first practice run, I actually got blown up because my opponents were flying right behind me and they passed me up right after I used a boost and I blew up. And if you hear that, there's a train passing by, so you may hear that. And you'll also be hearing the clicking of this controller, since GameCube controllers have all plastic for just about everything. So the noisiest controllers you'll ever use. And here's Mos Eisley. And yes, you can destroy the city in its entirety. But we're not here for that, we're just here to find whatever we can. I do have a strategy guide for this game, but I'm not going to bother bringing that out, which brings up the question, if I'm going to try to find any of the power-ups in this game, I may try to find one or two, but there's only, I'd say, one that I know where they are.
Press the green button and then release it. Press it again to link your lasers.
And I think in this game, they actually don't refer to it as the A button or anything. They call it the green button. Your lasers are linked. Oh, yes, and this whole linked lasers thing. Basically, all you have to do is wait until that little meter around the proton torpedo on the bottom right-hand corner. When the thing fills up, your lasers are at their full power. You can fire it. Essentially gives your lasers a full power. There's really no point in worrying about it, since it takes just as long to destroy a target with your lasers linked as it does just holding the button down, so there's really no point in doing it. The only real purpose of doing linked is if you're trying to go for accuracy bonus. Yeah, let's see, maybe we need to find some more things. Yeah, and usually, this is a level that takes a lot of exploration if you want to really memorize where everything is. But, since... Yeah, we found the crate dragon.
Good job. You found the crate dragon bones. You found another Bantha herd. Now look for the other three.
Banthas.
The X button switches between the rear view and the cockpit view. Try it now. Good work.
Yeah, the thing about the cockpit view is I'm not a big fan of it. Some Star Wars games where there's flight sim parts, I'm alright with it, but in other parts it's usually just best to do the third person view.
Excellent.
That is just kind of awkward looking on this thing.
Race against Biggs through Beggar's Canyon.
I will say the first person view is better if you're doing Now this track right here can help you somewhat train for the first mission since you're destroying a Death Star, but I never really did that, so it's just some good practice, but I mean it's no big deal if you pass up on doing this race. Now there are two tracks you can choose. Track 1's shorter, but it's a bit more challenging. And track 2 is longer, but... And like that, see, I just showed that you can easily get killed from having your opponent fly into you. But yes, with track 2 it's longer, but it's easier to fly through. And there's a way of memorizing this track so that way you can fly through the Beggar's Canyon and get a shortcut. And then you'll be able to beat your opponent by a few seconds or so. Yeah, and if you are trying to do a little bit of an ace, like, flight simming kind of thing, you pretty much have to hold down the Z button the whole way.
Good job.
Now let's keep exploring this. And yes, if you do fly too far away, it'll force you to come back. Oh yeah, back at Tashi Safe Station where I did that other race, R2 and the escape pod somewhere around there. That's the one thing about this game, is that there's a lot of exploration you have to do if you want to try to complete everything. I mean, I use a guide to complete mine when I did my 100% run.
You found a Dubak. Now find the other two.
It is interesting, though, how on Tatooine these civilians can fly around essentially what's military equipment, considering he has laser cannons, proton bombs, and an ion cannon. But then again, there are variants of this T-16 that are not armed, but are more of a civilian version. Now, unfortunately, this is the only level that has a day-night cycle that's linked to the console. There's a level later in the game that does have a day-night version based on what time you're playing. But it doesn't have the sun or the and everything tracking. It just has one set to day, one set to night. It would have been cool, though, if they had for it on more levels, but in this case, they don't. Couldn't find the other things. I know there's a crashed TIE fighter around here. And the crashed TIE fighter should be right there.
Good job, you found the crashed TIE fighter.
Yeah, for some reason, everything blows up in this game. Even when you shoot animals, they blow up.
You found another Dubak. One more to go.
Right now, I'm just flying around, just because I think I've completed all the training things other than redoing the racing. Yeah, let's try the race again. I'm gonna choose the other path.
Race against Biggs through Beggar's Camp.
Luke, I'm taking the shortcut. It's a little complicated, but a good way to test your flying skills. Let's go, Biggs. I can take anything you can dish out.
Yeah, another thing too is that you can be disqualified for flying out of the canyon. So just be careful with your attitude.
Farm boy, When did you get so good? Hey, I told you I've been practicing.
You know, like that track 2 is the easier one. It's longer, but usually if you know how to time your boosts and everything, you should be alright. And then track 1 is just more just being wary of your surroundings because it's easy to get lost in it.
Luke, I'm taking the shortcut. It's a little complicated, but a good way to test your flying skills. Let's go, Biggs. I'm up for the challenge.
Mission. Yep, stay like that because I flew too quick.
Found another bantha herd. Two more to go.
Yeah, just about all those things.
You can destroy this target only when your lasers
lies. I'm actually considering on end. I would end this earlier, but I just want this training mission just to time out on its own. Yeah, compared to the first time I played this, the whole year of Star Wars thing was a lot shorter to rant about since I pretty much covered a lot of what I ranted more review-wise in my not reviewing any more thing video, so. Yep, there we go. Time's up. Alright, so after that you do have the option to restart training. Just to, you know, take care of whatever you needed to do. And there's all your time shifts you usually have to beat if you want to get credit for whatever it is there. And aside from that, that's it. You really, it's completely optional to do Tatooine training. It's something I would recommend to people who have never played a Rogue Squadron game before, but other than that, that's Tatooine training. So we'll see you next time with the Death Star.